in the last session we have seen the difference between a fuse and a circuit breaker. In today's session we will see about the introduction of circuit breakers. First of all, before being going to see what is circuit breaker and its function, we'll just see the need for the circuit breaker. So as we know that the fuse requires replacement after every operation. So whenever a fuse blows out, in that case it takes some time to rewire it. The next thing is, this fuse cannot interrupt the heavy fault currents. So these are the two drawbacks. One is a replacement problem, another is it cannot interrupt the heavy fault current. So this necessitates to go in for your circuit breaker for protecting the various power system components against damage, such as the protection of distribution transformer or your lighting circuit, etc. Now we will go on to the principle of circuit breakers. What the circuit breaker is going to do? So this circuit breaker, it is nothing but it either makes the circuit or breaks the circuit. So either it does it manually or you can do it by remote control. The next thing is, so whenever it is going to break the circuit under fault condition, it does automatically. So these are the two main principles of circuit breaker. So this circuit breaker, fuses and the relays, all these equipments are used for switching and controlling your equipment. So all these three put together, fuses, circuit breakers, switches, relays, all this is called as a switch gear. So which is used for switching and controlling the power system equipment. Okay, so now we will see what is the operation of circuit breaker. If you could see in circuit breaker, one of the main problem is the arcing between the contacts. So as we all know, circuit breaker will have two contacts, moving contact and a fixed contact. Whenever a fault occurs or a short circuit occurs, in that case a heavy fault current, so it will pass through, and in that case, in order to interact, so this moving contact is going to move apart from your fixed contact and the arc quenching medium is going to flow through and quench the arc as soon as possible to protect the power system components against damage. So here it is not that as we do in our home, just onning and offing a fan switch or a light switch. Here under a short circuit condition, a heavy fault current is going to exist. In that case, interrupting just like that is not an easy phenomenon. It is a real time situation, right? So in this case, so whenever a short circuit or a fault is going to occur, in that case the current is going to increase. When the magnitude of the current level is increasing, the temperature is going to increase. So in this case, whatever the heat which is going to be produced when the moving contact is moved apart from the fixed contact, at the same time, so the arc quenching medium such as air or oil will flow through to quench the arc. So at the initial stage, whatever is the heat which is going to be present, it is going to vaporize this air or oil. So whenever this is going to vaporize, what happens? Automatically the ionized particles of air or vapor are going to be formed. In turn, what it will happen? It will act as a arcing path. It acts as a short circuiting path. Okay, so at the initial stage. So what happens? Whenever the contacts are open, the potential difference is going to be small. So even this small potential difference will be enabling it to maintain the arc. Okay, it provides a low resistance path. So this low resistance path is sufficient enough to maintain the arcing here. So under, whenever a fault occurs, so this moving contact is going to move apart. It is not that you cannot off the circuit immediately, you cannot interrupt the arc immediately. An arc will be struck. This is a main problem of circuit interruption in your circuit breaker. So the main concern for a protection engineer is that, so this arcing should be quenched as soon as possible so that this low resistance path does not exist and it tries to continue to carry the current. Okay, so now we should find some mechanism wherein we have to increase the arc resistance. In other words, we try to remove the ionized particle from the path, or in other words, I have to increase the arc resistance so that the arc gets quenched. I have to flow a lot of arc quenching medium. It can be either oil or air or SF6 or your vacuum or air blast. So by some means it is our utmost necessity that the arcing product should be removed so that the fixed contact remains apart from your moving contact. Now we will see the mechanisms by which you can increase the arcing so that the current gets decreased and the arc extinguishes. So this is going to be your main criteria. Now here we will see what are the factors that contributes to your for increasing the arc. The first thing is that it is a degree of ionization. So whenever the ionized particle decrease, I can increase the resistance of the arc, thereby I can quench the arc as soon as possible. The second thing is length of the arc. You know the general formula, R is equal to rho L by A. In that case, if I want to increase the arc resistance, that is facilitated by increasing the length of the arc. The next thing, by reducing the cross section of the arc, I can increase the arc resistance. So I should find a means by which I can increase the arc resistance, so which is employed by either the degree of ionization, or I am going to increase the length of the arc, or I am going to decrease the cross section of the arc. So now we will see, whenever we are going to go in for your arc extinction process, so two main factors governs it. One is, what is the potential difference that is going to be existing between the contacts. To an extent we can say, if I am going to increase the distance, the potential difference will be less, so immediately I can quench the arc. But in this also there is a drawback. When we are moving for a high voltage applications, we cannot move the fixed and the moving contact several meters apart. In that case it becomes impracticable. The second condition is, what is the other means? So I have to remove the ionized particle from the parking, from the arcing path. In this case, I can either cool the arc, or I have to remove the ionized particle from the arc, thereby I can quench the arc as soon as possible. So either I can increase the distance in case of the small circuit breaker applications, or I have to remove the ionized particle by increasing the arc resistance, or I have to remove the ionized particles from the path by suitably quenching by using the suitable cooling medium. So with this basic concepts in mind, in the next class, so we will be seeing about what are the different types of arc extinction methods. Thank you.